So now what?
BBC.
In a second, sure.
No, come out here, please.
And pick it up from the middle actually made it more difficult.
Is if you look at the two of you side by side, you and John Deacon.
Oh boy, yep, there we are.
When you put that wig on, I mean, you are transformed.
Yeah, there's Dad.
Like, their music's so universal, it's so recognizable, but I think actually often people don't realize that the songs they're hearing are Queen. And I hope and I think that people will watch this film and go, oh wow, they wrote that one. And what's great is, like, I think there's a danger of taking their music for granted. You know, Bohemian Rhapsody, for instance, you hear it so often, you don't think much of it. But what this film does is go back to the origins of songs like that and really imagine what it must have been like for these four great minds to come together and create something so unique, and really imagine what that is like.
Wow.
Hello, Rami and Gwil and Joe. It's Brian here. I just want to say thank you for doing the most incredible job, not only making the film and being us, but being out there working your asses off. Am I allowed to say that? To sell the thing, you know, and get the news out there. It's incredible. We're right at that point where it's about to burst on the public. I cannot wait. Thank you, guys. Love ya.
Oh, what a lovely
guy. Love you too.
He really is.
I've got better things to do on my Saturday nights. I could give you their names.
Sorry.
Did you learn a lot about what it must have felt like to have such a huge fandom to basically be a legend?
No, I didn't. I've learned a lot about what it means to have great friends and what it means to live your best life.
I said, whoever threw that coffee machine, your mom's a hoe.
I'm here because there's an immigrant man who took it upon himself to push himself in the most extraordinary way. He's bisexual, gay, moved from Zanzibar to London with a fish out of water, and somehow stepped on stage and told everyone they could be exactly who they wanted to be. They could be audacious, they could be bold, they could be irreverent, they could be inclusive and authentic and their best selves. He's allowed me to feel that way. He allows all of us to feel that way. This is because of and for Freddie Mercury.
You call me sweet like I'm some kind of
It's good.
Is that, you know, when my hand's on your grease gun, that's very subtle.
It's just a bit weird, Roger. What exactly are you doing with that car?
Children, please.
There's only room in this band for one hysterical.
I know what I'm doing. I got a feeling I should be doing all right.
Whatever it was, damn sexy. Damn sexy.
Get all my stuff out of here and you can really relax. Hey, mate. I've been in here for 2 days, mate. I can hardly breathe in here.
Bohemian Rhapsody is in theaters now. See you next week on Couch Surfing.
Fit for a queen, you get it?
No, fit for a queen,
fit
yes.
Fit for a queen?
No, very good.
Very good.
You can take that out of my royalty.
Twat!
Wanker!
You can shove your gold discs. You made a mistake, Fossler.
Go kill him, boys. Kill him, kill him.
But there's a hint of kind of an Indian accent underneath it all. You say something like, this song is only dedicated to beautiful people here tonight. And as you can hear it, only dedicated to beautiful people here tonight.
Are you joking?
No.
Are you joking?
She keeps a Moët Chandon in a pretty cabinet. Let them eat cake, she says, just like Marie Antoinette. A building remedy for Khrushchev and Kennedy. At any time, an invitation you can't take.
Yeah, well, speaking of which, we've got Golden Globes on Sunday. You got your tux ready, you got your date ready.
All of it, yeah.
Yeah, you ready to go?
Yeah.
I can't wait to see what you wear. Are you going to channel some Freddie maybe for award show season?
Maybe one or two moments, but you know, you got to keep it classy and dignified for a few of these things. Not that he wasn't. It was just there are moments for being audacious.